Hello everyone. In this episode, I want us to start working on our navbar component. So I'll just open the navbar component from my Visual Studio Code. And for our navbar, we'll only have a logo and a cat icon. So right here, I wrap everything with the nav element. So I'll delete this, include the nav element, and I'll also give it a class name of a nav bar. So right here I'll say nav hyphen bar, and then in between our nav bar we will have a h2 for our logo. So it's just a simple text logo, and I'll say online shop, and then at the bottom here is where we will have our cat icon. So right here I'll just include a div with a class of navbar. So let's grab the SVG icon from Bootstrap icons. I'll just come at Google here and search for Bootstrap icons, and then I'll click here and so right here I'll search for bug, and I want to use this handbag fill as our cat icon. So I'll select this, and then I'll copy this SVG using that icon, and I'll paste it right here. Now if I save, I have a prettier, which is a code formatter. It will auto format my code. And right here I want to change this class to class name, since in JSX we don't use class, we use class name. And then I'll manually edit the width and the height right here. So instead of 16, I want this to be big. I'll have 35 and this one to be 35. And then we want to display how many items we will be having at our cart. So right here I'll just add a span with a class of bag quantity, and then inside our span we can have another span which will now have the actual quantity. For now we'll just have a placeholder. Let's say we have 3 items in our cart, but later on we'll be able to dynamically display this number depending on how many products we will be having in our cart. Now earlier on in the last episode we added React Router DOM in our application, and now we can be able to direct our logo here to a specific route, which is our home route, and then our navbar here to the cart route. So what we need to do is to import a component from React Router DOM called link. So right here I'll import link from React Router DOM, and this is a component. We can wrap it on our heading here. So right here I'll say link, and I wrap our heading with this link component, and it will have a prop right here which will direct us to a specific path. So right here you can say link to, and we have our home route as just a slash. Now we will do the same for our nav bag. So right here we'll add a link component, and we will say to, and we registered our cart route. So when we click on this navbar icon, we'll be redirected to our cart. So I'll highlight everything that we have here for our navbar and bring it at the top here. So this is it for the JSX for our navbar. Now we'll need to style everything using CSS. So first of all, let's see what we have. I'll come to our online shop, and you can see we have our heading and we have this icon. Now when we click on the icon here, we'll be redirected to the cart component. When we click on the online shop here, we are redirected to the home component. So that is nice, but let's style this using a CSS. So I'll be doing all the CSS in our app.css file. And you can see we already have some CSS here. I'll just highlight everything and remove it, okay? And we'll start from scratch. Now, the first thing that I want us to do is to grab a nice font for our application. So I'll just go to Google Fonts. I'll search for Google Fonts. Go to Google Fonts. And then from here, I'll search for Nunito. So this is the font that we will be using. You can use a different font if you want. So I'll select Nunito there. And from our list here, I'll select the 200 style. And then I'll select the regular 400. And I'll also select a bold, which is 700. And I'll come to import here because I want to import on a CSS file. Select whatever is between our style tags and copy that. And then I'll come back to our app.css and paste that particular link. Now we have our font imported here. And then the first thing that we can do right here is to select all the elements. And what I like to do is to remove the padding for all the elements and set this to zero, to remove all the margin and set this to zero. And then we will also set the box sizing to border box. So normally it's usually content box, but when we set it to border box, when we set a width of a particular element and add padding and border, that padding and border will be included in the width of the element, so it won't increase its width. Now right here, we can start now working on our nav bar. Now when we look at the way we have arranged our elements here in our nav bar, we have two child elements. We have this link and we have this link. So we can be able to use Flexbox to display these two links side by side and also create some spacing between them. So the first thing that we will do is to obviously select that navbar class. So I'll say navbar, and then we will give it a height of about 70px, and we can also give it a background right here of black. And now we can be able to say display of flex, and then we can justify the content to be space between, and we align the items to be at the center. Now if you have never used Flexbox before, this display of flex will simply create what we call a flex container. And then in our flex container, since this is the parent here, we will have two flex items. This will be the first flex item, and this will be the second flex item. So by default, the flex direction will be in a row, meaning that this will be side by side in a row. So if we check at this and come right here, I think I need to refresh or save this file. So I messed up a class name here. This is supposed to be double S. I need to save that. So let's see what we have. Now you can see we already have a very simple navbar. We have this online shop on this side and this cart icon on this side. So we need to style the individual components there. and also to create a spacing at the end here. So let's see how we can do that. So what I'll do, I'll simply add a padding to our navbar here, and top and bottom I'll give it to be 0px or rather 0, and then left and right I'll give it 4m. And then now right here I'll start by selecting the h2. I'll say navbar h2, and for the h2 all we will do is to increase its font size to 40px. And then for the nav bag, so this is a class name. What I want with this is to have the 3 here and our bag here to be side by side, and so I want to just push these 3 at the center. So if we look at our nav bag, you can see inside our nav bag, which is this div, we have an SVG and then we have a span tag. So this SVG and the span tag here will be our flex items when we add a display of flex to this. So we can say at our app.css display of flex, and we align the items at the center, and that will make them to be at the center. Now we need to style these 3 to look like a small icon with a number in there, and we gave it a class of bag quantity. So if I come here, you can see we gave this span a class name of bag quantity. So we can select that class name .bag-quantity, and I'll add some stylings here. I'll add a display of flex, and I'll center whatever we have in our bag quantity, which is our number. So this particular span with a number. So right here, we can add align items of center, justify content of center, and I'll give it a height and a width. So a height of about 25px and a width of 25px. So they are both equal. And then we will give it a background color, or rather a background of yellow. And then we want it to be a circular. So with circular, we'll just add a border radius of 50%. So let's see what we have with this. Now you can see we have this icon there. It should be circular. So our border radius is not working. So this is supposed to be border radius. I will save that, and there we go. Now we have a circle and a 3 there. We can make our 3 to be bold and increase its font size. So right here I can say a font size of about, I'll actually decrease the font size for our 3. So I'll set the font size of 14px and we make it to be bold. So font weight of 700. And then the color for our text will be black. So color black. And lastly here, we can give our bag quantity a margin left. So right here, say a margin left of 5px, and that will create some spacing between our bag here and our icon there. Now you can see the way our links look like. When we added our link component around them, an a tag was automatically added to them. So if we inspect this, you'll see that we have an anchor link. So we come to elements here. Now you'll see we have an anchor link wrapping them, and the href is the path that we included. So we need to remove the stylings for the anchor link. And what I'll do, I'll come to app.css. I'll do that just after our navbar here. So I'll select our navbar, and then I'll select all the anchor link in our navbar. And all we will do for this is to remove the text decoration. So I'll set this to none, and then I'll give here color to be white. Now when you come back, let's refresh. Nothing is actually happening. So this is navbar, not navbug. So I'll save that. Then let's see. Now there we go. So now we have a decent navbar for our online shop, where we have just a logo here to go to home, and we have a nice icon with a count of how many items we have at our cart to go to our cart. So you can see we are at cart. When you click this, now we are at home. So that is it for this episode, and in the next episode we will see how we can add a not found component and direct a user to that not found component whenever they enter an invalid route. So I'll see you in the next one.